Welcome to Stretching for Optimal Social Distance, Part 3. As I have mentioned in previous classes, today's class, the classes this week, and in the future are going to just get a little bit shorter because I am prepping to go back into my regular work schedule. We are starting non-traditional instruction for our schools here in Jefferson County, which if you're not local is Kentucky. But, so in order to give myself some prep time for that, because it takes a shocking amount of prep time to get everything set up to work online, as I'm sure some of you already know. So we're shortening our classes a little bit, but that does not mean they'll be any less in value, just less on your time. So we are gonna get right into it. Today's series focuses on mobility through our flexibility and through our bodies. So opening up our bodies in a more functional way. We started focusing on this last time with dynamic stretches. So these are also dynamic stretches. You'll see a few familiar ones in this series. But we're gonna start in our tabletop position, just working through some cat-cow. So really releasing, keeping those shoulders down, then really contracting. Noticing where you're keeping your weight, trying to evenly distribute. And bringing yourself back into a neutral position. We're going to think of our hips drawing big circles in the space. So you may have to move your hands a little further forward. Circling the hips down and back, forward and around. Seeing how far you can drop through your pelvis. Again, if anything's not feeling okay, maybe go a little slower, a little less in those areas. We're trying to wake up the body, not kill it right out the starting gate. Again, if any parts need a little extra TLC, give that TLC. And then circling the other direction. Maybe even kind of going back and forth, that's okay too. Noticing how your shoulders engage. Finally, coming back through center and pulling back into our child's pose. Breathing into this, relaxing our hips down toward our heels. We're about to go through a series that really awakens our mobility through our spine and our back. And overall, our body just transitioning to different positions should get us nice and warm for some deeper stretches. But for now, just allowing our body weight to carry us down, down, down. Rounding up, sliding down and through into our cobra, just a gentle stretch for now. And then we're gonna lower through our arms. Keep those elbows pulling down and in, back and in. From here, I'm not gonna use my arms, I'm gonna use my back. My hands are just there for safety and security. Lifting up, 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 waking up those back muscles, leaving your legs on the floor, coming back down. We're going to use our hands this time to push up, give that stretch again, shoulders wide and down, Then I'm going to bend one arm, twist over the shoulder. Back through center again. This is all mobility, so we want to keep it moving. And back to center. Here's where it gets a little harder. We come back down and squeeze those elbows in. We're going to lift out again using the back muscles. Legs released into the floor. Arms go out to the sides. Carry them up, up, up above the head. And lower. Planting those hands on the floor. I'm going to lift my pelvis up and drag my chest across the floor. Pull, pull, pull. Sweep the floor. Back into my child's pose. Rolling up through my spine to sit on my heels. And this go around, we're just going to think of tilting the head to the side, circling through the neck, all the way around. Waking up that neck. And circling the other direction. Finding that head and neck back in center. Nice stacked vertebrae. We're going to release down through our spine, back into our child's pose. Hands coming out and forward. Rounding up through the spine. Repeating that series. Stretching up. Elbows in as we lower down slowly. Just the back lifting. Up. And deepening the stretch, pushing with our arms. Bend one arm and twist. And back through center, bend the other arm, twist. Back through center, lowering down again, squeezing the elbows in. Should be using your arm muscles. Just the back muscles, back up, arms out.
Sorry.
Bonus points if you knock over your water. Arms up. And lowering back down. I hate that one, but it's so good for us. Pressing hips up all the way back into our child's pose, rolling up to sit. Using this roll up to deepen the stretch through our back. This time we're gonna move into our side stretch a little bit. So head to shoulder. Dripping down, down, down. I want to leave my sits bones connected to my heel. So just getting as much of a stretch through my side as I can. Carrying that arm up and over. Long arm, shoulder down. And bringing that arm back up. There'll be lots of side stretching here. Restacking those vertebrae. Head tall and center, tilting to the other side. Dripping, dripping, dripping. Once you've found that maximum stretch, that arm can reach up and over. Start that series, so stretching through the back, all the way down, lifting through our spine, sliding those hands forward as needed, stretch that cobra, shoulders wide and down, lower, just the back lifts, and lower, This time pushing up, deepen that stretch. Bend one arm and twist. And going back through center and using those arms. Hey.
Hello.
Back through center. Back down, elbows in. Lifting out and up through the back. Arms to the side. Carrying those arms high. I need a stronger back and lowering. And hips up, sliding back. Again, using this time, rolling through. Just stretch, stretch, stretch that back out. And then stack. We're gonna flex that hand to the side. Tilt that head to the other direction. Carry the other arm up, give her its neck a little stretch. Right now our head is facing forward. We're gonna tilt it down a little angle, get into that back of the neck. Really pressing the shoulder down. Let it go. Head restacks. Flex that other hand. Press that shoulder. Tilt that head. Reach. And just a little light pressure from that top hand. Finding a center, we're going to tilt to one side, open, 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 feel the expansiveness of the body. Again, staying nice and warm so that our stretches have somewhere to go, and coming back through. Rocking through those feet just one more time, and other side. Center. From here, we are folding up into our downward dog. Take a little walk through those feet, really pressing through the toes, releasing the heels down toward the floor, widening the toes on the floor. First, I'm going to take that left heel straight up to the ceiling. It's not going to go very high yet. We're not warm there.
As you take it all the way up.
And then I'm bringing that knee into my chest and trying to bring that left foot forward between my hands. And we're just releasing here for a second. We're about to do some twisty stuff. But again, right now, we're just starting to wake up that hip flexor stretch. It's going to get deeper and deeper as we go. With my left foot forward, I'm going to plant my right hand into the floor and twist up. You might feel a little in your glute. Make sure these shoulders are pressing down. Make sure that back leg is straight. And lowering back. Now I'm going to rotate my back foot so it's open. And I'm pressing into that back hand to twist up towards the ceiling. Falling is acceptable and encouraged. It means you're trying something unfamiliar. I'm only laughing at him because I deeply and truly love him, so we have that relationship. And coming back through center, planting those toes back on our mat. From here, this is the one that I think is bloody murder for the best reasons. I'm gonna go ahead and take my arm to the inside of my leg. So my left and right arm are on the same side, which is right now the right side. I'm going to twist so that my hip comes down to the floor. I'm trying not to move that front leg. If you are like me and have a very tight butt, this may feel awful for you if you leave your foot there. You might roll to the outside edge of your foot. That is okay. And you might feel a stretch through your side body. And we can take that left arm up. Or if you need it for support, that's also welcome. And bringing that arm back down, rotating back into our lunge, reestablishing that position. Giving ourselves just a quick press of the pelvis down, and then dropping that back knee, straightening out that front knee in front of us. So while we're here, we're just gonna try and lengthen through our back. Thinking of our sits bones reaching back out behind us, not curling down toward the floor. Reach back with that pelvis. Since it's my left leg forward, I'm going to think of my right hand being planted as I twist to lift my left arm, making sure we're not lifting that hip, keeping the hip down. Lowering one more time. I'm going to go ahead and while I'm lengthening through my back here, flex that foot, spread out my toes, and if you can, you can go ahead and thread your fingers through those toes in front. It's like you're holding a very strange baby's hand. You can tell that my captivity is getting to me. And flexing that foot, widening those feet. And letting it go, pointing through that foot. I'm gonna go ahead and lower in the back. From here, I'm trying to release forward, but again, thinking of the pelvis, reaching out behind me, not rounding through here, reaching back. I'm gonna think of exhale, lower.
Inhale, lengthen through that spine.
Exhale, lower.
Inhale, lengthen through.
Exhale, lower.
Inhale, lengthen.
One more. Exhale, lower.
Inhale, lengthen.
And as we lengthen, we're this time coming up onto our knee. This one might be familiar. We're thinking of, instead of just keeping the hips released, pressing the pelvis forward. So engaging those lower abdominals. I should feel like I'm squeezing my butt. And while I'm here, I'm just gonna start taking a couple little bounces forward to get into that hip flexor. Real slow, so not fast bounces, real slow to get maximum benefit. Last one, we're drawing. dropping down again. So pushing that pelvis forward. Now I'm taking my left arm overhead. Oh, I'm sorry, my right arm overhead. My left side. To further open up through that hip flexor. And bring that arm down. Releasing up. I'm going to rotate this leg. So now I'm kind of 90 degrees this way and 90 degrees that way. Stretching forward, hand to the floor. Got a little side stretch in. Might feel a little bit in the inner thigh. And reaching that arm up and over, pressing through that front leg. I'm gonna straighten it and take my right hand to the floor. And take that left arm overhead, stretching my side. Long, long, long arm up top, reaches back up as I start bending my front leg to lift my torso up and over, rotating back toward that front. And now I'm just pressing down, no press of the pelvis. Just a little release here. Tucking those toes. Oh, I'm sorry, one more. Taking that back leg up, bending it. I'm going to swim my left arm to grab my right foot in the back. Trying to stay as released forward as I can. Not on that kneecap. That's not comfortable for anybody. Get my hip down into the floor. bringing up that top arm if you're able. Back down, rotate, 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 reset those hands. Enjoy this comfortable, normal position. Press, 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 press those hips down. Drop that knee, straighten that front leg. And from here, just starting lengthening through our spine. No rounding here. Lengthen those, help that pelvis back. I'm gonna plant my left hand on the floor. Think of lifting up my right arm, but not my right hip. So drop that hip down. Widening those toes, you're gonna grab, thread your fingers through to widen the foot, and stretching down. How you doing?
Great.
I love you.
I know.
I do. And letting it go, reaching all the way down. Here we're exhaling to curve over. Again, making sure those sit bones are reaching back, not rounded into our heels, but reaching beyond our heels. Rounding.
Inhale, straighten through that back.
Exhale, round.
Inhale, straighten up.
Exhale, round.
Inhale, straighten up.
One more. Exhale, round.
Inhale, straighten up.
And coming up onto that knee, we're rounding our pelvis forward and just taking it so we're feeling that stretch through our hip flexor. One more, stopping at our maximum point. Right side, carry that left arm. Left arm overhead. Dynamic moment here. This is just about releasing, feeling the fold of the thigh, release through the hip socket. I'm gonna swim that right arm as I pick up that back leg, grab that foot. And don't lift up onto that kneecap. We wanna press all the way down as best we can. Straightening up again, we are going to move into our closer cool down. Yes, I do have notes in front of me, I'm sorry. My brain is at capacity. So from here, I'm sliding that back foot in, finding my forward fold, and then just thinking of releasing down and forward. I want soft knees, so no locking and tightening, softening, even a micro bend is okay. Exhale, release. Inhale and lengthen through that spine. Exhale down. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale down. Inhale and lengthen. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale down. And we're gonna walk those feet out just a little bit. So soft turnout. I'm gonna go ahead and walk myself over to my right side, stretching down, planting that right hand, or sorry, my left hand. I'm gonna open up my right arm to the ceiling, making sure we're not shifting our hips as we do this, but keeping it centered. And bring that arm down. This time opening to the front. Again, no shifting of the hips, keeping it centered. And back down. Through center, I'm going to take a deep plie, grab those hands behind my back, and as I straighten up, allowing them to release forward. If you're able, when you grab, to keep your palms together, you can go for that. You used to be better at that, no more. And plie again, bring those arms down and in. Drop them to the floor. We're gonna expand up, walking it to our left side. Picking that left arm up, rotate to the back. And bring it back down. This time, picking that right arm up again, watching those hips. And bringing it back down. Walking ourselves to center. One last thing, we're opening up those feet into a wider turnout, bending those knees. We're going to plant our elbows inside those thighs. relax and not. No, I don't even know what to call this. No hermit, no hermit crab. Ah, taking that left hand, placing it inside the knee, shoulder turned in, looking over the right shoulder. Switch right hand, left elbow, right shoulder, turn to your left. And finding our center one last time. I'm going to lengthen through those legs, rotate in just a little bit, press down, bend those knees, rounding and leaning. Leaving the arms and head heavy as we roll, roll, roll up. Walking those feet in. And just taking a moment to feel what's going on in your body. How does it feel? Maybe you wiggle through it a little bit. It's feeling kind of like, ah! Grab some water if you need. Get some nourishment. That is our class for today. So kind of a quick, very active stretch. You can always take any of that stuff way slower than what we just did, but it's very thorough, and especially the lower half of the body and mobilizing the top half of the body, as if you want to go into some deeper stretching there. But we look forward to seeing you tomorrow for Modern Dance for Couch Potatoes Part 3. And Friday, we have some choreography coming your way. Next week, we are going to be doing a choreography, not really challenge so much as class. So we're using it as a way to kind of document how, what our experiences are, what we're feeling during this COVID-19 disease and coronavirus crisis and pandemic, so that we have something to look back on. So if you'd like to participate in that, it should be real short installments every day, and that should go along with some of our regularly scheduled classes. Hey, have a great day. I'll see you tomorrow.